I mean, it seemed to me simply at that point that I simply must become a conscientious objector. I couldn't go and do something of that sort. But I simply didn't have the nerve to face my society and say, no, I won't. Now I know that, for instance, Bill Stafford, whom I lived near to there in Iowa City, had done 4 years as a conscientious objector. And as a matter of fact, he was taken out with a bunch of other conscientious objectors someplace in the South, and they had the rope around his neck already when the sheriff arrived. I didn't have that kind of nerve, and so I went. I think, as a matter of fact, that many of the people felt much as I did, that they would go and try to do something of that sort. But as a matter of fact, it later came out that during World War II, 3/4 of the men in combat were unable to pull a trigger. The guns all jammed, they thought. Now they put people through a kind of psychological training so that they become more able to kill other people. Anyway, I simply didn't have that. I went ahead, and I became a... They sent us to Saipan, where I became a brig guard, and I ended up doing some things that really are fairly disgraceful. They brought... one night, the SPs, Shore Patrol, brought aboard the ship two guys who were drunk on the beach, and we threw them in the brig. Later that night, they claimed they'd been raped by some of the guys in the other guys in the brig. Whether this was so or not, of course, we would never know. Things of that sort happened, not infrequently.